What time is it? You know what time it is. It's time to hit that subscribe button. You know just where it's at. Right down there. Right down there. And it's time to follow my Instagram. That's Geekly Amanda. G-E-E-K-L-Y Amanda. It's the same on Twitter. Make sure to follow me there too. And it's time to get this series review started. Series Nine Perfect Strangers dropped on Hulu this week, Wednesday, the first three episodes, and let me tell you, it's based off of a novel, and it has some big stars in this. Nicole Kidman, Melissa McCarthy, I mean, there's a star-studded cast. But is it worth watching? Well, let me tell you a little bit first about what it's about. So, Nine Perfect Strangers is about nine strangers who, you know, who are on the path to find a better them. And they all check into this 10-day resort, which is a health and wellness resort, promised to give them healing and transformation. Nine Perfect Strangers kind of reminded me a bit of The White Lotus, which just had its finale on HBO Max. Like The White Lotus, strangers all come together at a resort. This time it's a health and wellness resort other than just a tropical resort, right? And you know, each of these strangers have their own set of problems and struggles. We have like a family, you know, trying to get over a suicide, the death of, you know, a family member that committed by suicide. They have, you know, an old football player who's struggling through, like, he had shattered his knee and some pain through that. They have a writer who's kind of on, you know, the downslope of her writing, kind of writer's block, but also just not producing anything and was let off by, like, you know, let go by her publishing company. So all of these strangers have these problems and they come together at this resort for healing and transformation. Along with this unique characters that come to the resort, the staff and actually director of the resort are kind of like a mystery in themselves. I mean, you have Nicole Kidman playing the Masha, who's the resort director, and you can already tell from like the first episode that she's dealing with like some own issues. I guess apparently she was killed and came back and had this spiritual, some kind of awakening, and that's what made her open this resort. So I mean, it's really intriguing, the whole concept of this, you know, from even the staff to the characters that come to the resort. It's a very intriguing concept plot. Now, we only have the first three episodes, but I'm hooked already. I am hooked from the beginning, you know. It reminded me, I love White Lotus, but also it has a little feel of The Big Little Lies and some of the same cast. Like, look, Nicole Kidman's in this as well. Produced and written, creator and writer, David E. Kelly, who we know, famous, you know, creator of many shows that we know. So, I mean, it has some big backing. I have really high hopes. And after seeing the first three episodes, I'm hooked. Let's talk about what the parents need to know before letting their kids watch this series. Now, it has some harsh language, and it's said throughout. It has the F word, the S word, the B word, the a-hole word. You're going to get, you know, bastard and all this stuff. So it's going to have some harsh language in this. The other mature content in this, I mean, you have some violence. Like I said, they had, you know, Masha, Nicole Kidman's character, who was shot and killed. And, you know, she came back. But you see, like, scenes of her going to the hospital, blood, you know, oozing out and puddles of blood. So, I mean, it's going to have some violent scenes. Other than that, I mean, it has some sexual scenes. We get kind of partial nudity where some characters are naked, but they really don't show anything. And we also get like sex scenes, implied sex, but also engaging in sex. You don't see too much, but like I said, you see some thrusting and things like that. So it has the mature content. And like I said, it has themes of like suicide, talking about suicide and death. And you know, this is not one for the very young ones. Teens, I would let my teens watch it. But, you know, you just have to, this is from the first three episodes, so I don't know what's to come in the others. This is after watching the first three episodes, what you're going to get. Dropped on Hulu this week. They dropped the first three episodes, and each episode's about 30 minutes to 45 minutes long, and I guess they're going to release more week by week. I'm in for it. I'm invested. It's an intriguing show. It's an intriguing concept, and I'm hooked already. If you've seen it, let me know what you think. Comments, thoughts, thumbs, and all that down below. And until next time, mwah!